So I understand that I've been talking to different people who've been involved with different parts of the revolution, and I understand that you work with a group that has been helping animals, like the horses and camels at the Giza pyramids. Could you talk a little bit about that? Like, what state did you find the animals in, and what first made you think there might be something you needed to help with?
You know, because the pyramids area, we will rely on tourism, and because of this incident in Egypt, so there is no tourist, so people affected, their income affected, and of course because they feed animals, so they don't have enough money to feed their animals, so animals start to starve, I would say starve, some of them, not all.
Yes.
The picture not completely dark, and there is of course some owners, they suffered, and they still really. And so some of the animals died.
Yeah, the horses and the camels?
Horses and camels and donkeys.
Yeah.
Because they can't feed themselves. I remember one of the guy, of the owners, he told me, how come I don't have 50 piastres in my home? So how you ask me to feed, take care of my camel, and I cannot take care of my children, myself.
Right.
So this is the point. So we start to collect money from here and there and make a petition to international organizations, animal welfare, organization, and they respond very quickly. They send some funds, and we started to feed. We have a project. I can forward the yesterday report attached with some photos.
Okay,
it's fantastic.
Yeah.
So we have 1 week. It will end next Monday. After that, another international animal welfare organization step in. And when they finish, we might go to Edfur, Luxor, to feed the animals, also the camels, the horses.
And how often have you been going out to the Giza pyramids to feed the animals there?
We are in a daily basis now. The project is for 1 week.
Yeah.
And when we finish this week, and we're going to start another week, sponsored by different organizations.
I see. Uh-huh.
And we might go, as I said, to Edfur, Luxor, after beginning of March.
Right. To your knowledge, is any group helping those animals yet?
Yeah, there is a lot of Egyptian groups helping. Yeah. There is other organization, Brook Hospital helping, another organization, NGO of course,
right,
helping, feeding. Donkey Sanctuary Egypt, Egypt Project, they also helping.
Uh-huh.
There is a lot of people, they're trying to do as much as they can.
And when you first went out to check on the animals, were any of them injured?
Yeah, injured because of actually, to be honest, cruelty, it's nothing to do with the crisis.
Mm.
There always been cruelty in this area, even before, because my organization, ESAF, the Egyptian Society of Animal Friends, we always, on a weekly basis, every Monday, we have a setup, we set up clinic in the pyramids area.
Uh-huh.
So we are in the area years since 2005.
Uh-huh.
So the cruelty, it's not something new.
Right, right.
It's always there, always wound, always injured animals, always.
Did any of them have any stabbings or things from the
No, I didn't see any stabbing, not at all,
I heard that there was a celebration hosted by, is that something you'd be comfortable talking about?
Yes, I've been there, but it's not, they're trying to say sorry.
Yeah.
And they're trying to explain this is not what the real thing happened.
Well, who is the they that you're talking about?
The pyramids, the owners, the camels, the stable owners who organized this anti-protesto.
Yes, yes.
And they tried to say
in Tahrir Square.
Yes. But they did it. They did the celebration in the pyramids area.
Yes, yes.
In the Tahrir.
Was that recently?
Last Thursday. Thursday. But actually, they are trying to say, oh, sorry, forgive us. We misled. Mm-hmm. They misled us, and they told us lies, and they cheated. They want us to go to Mohandesin, where is Mustafa Mahmoud Mosque. for pro Mubarak. I mean, people support Mubarak.
Right.
So, but they misled us and they told us, no, you have to go to Tahrir Square, and then the clash started from here.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
So they're trying to say, we didn't do a mistake, we just went to express how we feel, because this is our income, we don't have money.
Right.
That's it.
And how did the celebration go?
I passed by, I didn't attend because
okay.
I was very furious
mm-hmm.
with them. I spoke to a couple of guys I know before, and they tried, we are trying to fix it, but I didn't stay long.
And how are the animals doing now?
It's getting better, and tourist business coming back. But slowly. Of course, everybody's scared and cautious. So it will be back, but it will take some time.
And it's safe out there for tourists.
It is. Yeah, you can join us if you wish. You can join us. I'm going in half an hour. I'm going there. No, don't worry.
No. I maybe another day. I'd like.
Oh yeah, maybe. We are there for a week.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is it okay if I do a link to your website? It's Animal Friends, is that what
sure.
it is?
Sure, ESAF.
Okay.
ESAF.info.
Okay. Is it all right with you if I post this video on my blog?
You have my permission.
Okay.
You have my permission.
Right.
I'm the chairperson of Animal Friends.
Okay.
And the founder of the Egyptian Federation.
Yes.
And the founder of the Middle East Network for Animal Welfare consists of 19 countries, 33 organizations all over the region. Yeah. So you are free to do.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
And do you have another job aside from saving animals?
Of course, I'm a lawyer. I'm a lawyer before High Supreme.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
What's your first name?
Ahmed.
Thank you so much, Ahmed.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Bye bye.